Hi, and welcome to this tutorial for Elektronika. I've covered the basics of the user interface in my previous video, so now let's have a look at adding modules and playing a video. To add a module to the rack, right-click anywhere in the rack area and select Add Module. When you do this, a new list will appear with six categories of modules. Input-output modules are used to capture and play video and audio to and from the computer and other connected devices. Audio effect modules allow you to modify the audio inside of Elektronika. Currently, there's only one audio effect module, a three-band equalizer. Mixer modules allow you to mix between and combine various videos. 2D effect modules apply two-dimensional effects to video. Player modules allow you to play video stored on your hard disk. And 3D effect modules allow you to apply three-dimensional effect to videos. Let's start by adding the input-output module video out. This is a simple module which allows you to display video output on your screen. On the left of the module is a drop-down box. Clicking on it will show you a list of output options. For now, select a window. When you do this, you will see that a black box appears at the top left of your screen. This is the output window. To move it, simply click and drag. To change its size, you can click and drag its border, like so. Over on the left-hand side of the main window, I'm going to set this upper preview to the output of the video out module, so that I can always see my main output at a glance. This is especially useful if outputting to a second monitor or a projector. Okay, now that we have an output window, let's play some video. Right-click on the rack and select Add Module, Player, VP1 Player. Now that we have a player, we need to connect it to the output module so that we can see the video. To do this, we need to go to the back view of the rack. You can do this by either pressing Tab or by clicking this back button here. On the back of Elektronika modules are these red and orange squares. The red squares represent video input-output pins, and the orange squares represent audio input-output pins. Pins on the left side of a device are input pins, which means that they accept incoming video or audio for processing by the module. Pins to the right are output pins, which provide the video or audio processed by the module. If you hover over these pins, you can see a preview of their input or output. The VP1 player doesn't have any input pins, as we load files directly into it at the front, which I'll demonstrate in a moment. We need to connect the video output pin of the VP1 player to the first pin of the video out module by clicking and dragging a connection from the output pin here to the input pin here. Let's now go back to the front of the rack by pressing Tab or clicking the front button here. Open the file browser by clicking this arrow icon at the bottom right of the main window. I'm going to browse to the Elektronika installation folder. Click and drag the scroll in this box. You should now see these four clips. You can load these clips into the VP1 player by clicking and dragging them, like this. We're finally ready to produce some actual output. Click on the master play button here to start your set, and then click on the play button within the VP1 module here to start playing the video. Click on the loop button here to make the clip repeat. Click the master stop button to stop rendering. Note that clicking the master stop button doesn't automatically cause modules to stop. As you can see, the VP1 player is still playing, even though Elektronika has stopped. At this point, it's probably a good idea to get into the habit of saving regularly, so I click this icon here, Save As, and choose a file name and location for this project. Elektronika doesn't run with administrator privileges by default, so I need to save in an accessible directory, such as my documents. Alternatively, you can run Elektronika as an administrator by right-clicking on the .exe file and selecting Run as Administrator.